sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need to talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game. Attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a what's a toy? Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. With the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling. Duh. I ain't trying to make a living. I'm out here trying to make a killer. Stack a couple million to the ceiling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's
them gyal a red eye, never make right. Me they a suffer life, them a get by. Never bow for the fame, heads high. Never come into all, them a see a tear light. Been a real from the ghetto. I ain't never gon' switch, that's facts though. Can't get me out like stain. I'ma grow tough, I'ma know pain. Haters talk with a bad tongue. Can't break me, Tweedledee so dumb. I'ma be a giant leaf, 5-4 from doing it so big like Drake, I'm on one. My big box got me feeling so bossy. Like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty. Cause if my two loyal, then it's gon' cost me. And
that's just how I feel.
Yeah.
That's just how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, Rick Ross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the call. I find then I get low.
Tonight, from Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin, it's a special prime time edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers taking on Sam Darnold and the Carolina Panthers.
We are at the oldest continually operating stadium in the NFL as you get a look inside Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay, and this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Carolina Panthers. Mason Crosby of the Packers has it teed up, and off we go from Lambeau. Amir Abdullah going to take it out of the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. as we take a peek at Sam Darnold, the former USC Trojan and third pick in the 2018 draft.
And the thing with Sam Darnold is we know the skill set is there. May not be the most mobile or strongest arm quarterback in the league, but usually plays with really good poise and at his best, like a point guard in basketball, able to move around and distribute the rock.
They show run with three tight ends here on first down. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Here's second and 10. Now it's Darnold. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And they work this well upfield across the 45.
Hold on a second. Was that the fullback? That was the fullback. Who says it to slot receivers? But the only guys can catch the football and get big yardage after the catch. Really nice job there, showing good hands and an ability to get upfield.
Down. This is McCaffrey, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Adrian Amos up to make the tackle.
On that play, it was the defensive front that won the battle. They out-leveraged the offensive line, got into the backfield, and held him to no gain.
Second and 10. To throw is Darnold. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 42.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Darnold on first down. To the right side and complete to Thomas. Oh, that's just not fair. And now room to run. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. A big play that time through the air. 39 yards.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers, and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. McCaffrey, and he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Darnold, he lost the football. And this is going to be Packer football. Time to see the offense for Green Bay go to work. Aaron Rodgers leading them. What a career it's been. Came into the league back in 2005 as the number 24 pick out of Cal.
I remember watching him in college and seeing a guy that you knew had great potential, but I don't know that anyone knew that we would see how he would blossom as an NFL player who will go down as one of the all-time great quarterbacks, can make every throw, from every angle, with terrific mobility, and he knows how to win games, always in contention for a championship.
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 15. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
Not a lot of running room there, not a place to make a cut and kind of exit out because they had everything bottled up. Looked to me like the linemen were taking on their blocks really well and giving up no creases.
The last run got 3, now here's 2nd and 7. Play action, it's Rodgers. That ball is caught. Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big connection on that one. 32 yards. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Flush to his right. Another catch for Valdes-Scantling. And he'll be taken down by the face mask, it appeared. And yes, out come the flags.
Face mask. Defense.
So give him the yardage on the completion and also tack on 15 more.
If you get that hand up there, you've got to let go immediately or just not close the hand at all. He didn't, gave it a tug, and that was easy for the officials to see.
Escaping the pressure right. Now look out, Rodgers lost the football, and it's picked up by the Panthers. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. The 20. And he takes it into the end zone. It's a fumble recovery and a touchdown for the Panthers. How about that for a momentum swing? You had it goal to go. Not only do you cough it up, but they pick it up and return it all the way for a touchdown.
And now you have to give oxygen to the entire team because what a letdown that was. Terrific drive. Looked like you're going to get points. Instead, the other team registers them on the scoreboard.
Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. And this will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for 6. And you can bet they're preaching 2 hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, and he opted for the touchback. The Packers offense here coming back out for their 2nd drive. And that last possession, really a gut punch. You seemingly had it working. You were in the midst of a very strong drive, then suddenly the fumble, and you're watching the back of a defender's jersey as he brings it all the way in the other direction.
There's not much more I can add to that. I thought you summarized it perfectly, partner. You just got to regroup and start putting another drive together. That's all you can do.
And he'll push his way forward to about the 32.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he will have him. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. After the run by Jones, here's 1st and 10. Now they'll throw with Rodgers. Caught right side, it's Lewis. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. 2nd and right at a yard. Here's 2nd and a yard. Throwing is Rodgers. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
On third down, here's Jones. And Jones is not going to have the first down as they stop him short. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense, and know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. Out of the backfield, this is Aaron Jones. But he will not get away. He stops short of the marker. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And it'll be a turnover on downs. So they give it up just on their side of midfield. And, yeah, I mean, a surprising decision there to go for that.
Must have a lot of confidence in his defense. Must feel like, hey, we're in great shape here because our defense can hold them. Because they're really outside of field goal range now, all right, the opposite team. So if you hold them here, you haven't given up any points. You may give up a punt and you're pinned down a little bit. But must have thought it was an okay spot to go for it and decided to be aggressive.
Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout, and we will. We've got an injured Packer on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Darnold down to throw. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Aaron Stokes. And the Packers are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
Andy, you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart a little bit, and that's what we saw there. Didn't get enough on that throw, and it turned into an interception.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A big play that time through the air. 32 yards.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
On play action, Rodgers. He's going to try and go deep again. And it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively. And it'll bring up second down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
Rodgers again here on second and 10. A throw complete to the tight end, Tonyan. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20.
And I feel a little bit like a traitor as a former defender because that big man did not want to go down and refused to go down. If you're a defender and you'll get the right angle on a big tight end like him, he can run right through you like you're not even there. And he did a lot of that on that play.
That catch good for only a couple. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. That is caught at the 7. And the Packers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense could get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. Here's Rodgers to throw. He hauls it in. Valdez-Scantling for the Packers touchdown. Marquez Valdez-Scantling there to make the grab. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
Crosby with the extra point, and we are tied here in the second quarter. So that drive, 6 plays, 75 yards. And it ends with a Packers touchdown. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And Abdullah will not try to bring it out. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball, try and get things settled down a little bit.
The run only got 1 yard. Here's 2nd and 9. Now Darnold gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. A shotgun snap for Darnold. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Darnold. He'll find his man, Terrace Marshall, complete. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. The Panthers going to use the 2nd of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. To the air again, Darnold. Flushed out right. He's got the 1st down here inside the 30. And Darnold going to slide to the ground here, but not before he does pick up the 1st down. Last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
So not quite a 1st and goal just yet as they come up now 2nd and inches. Here's Darnold. He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. Now the Panthers going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Here's Darnold. Touchdown! Ian Thomas in the final seconds of the first half. And the Panthers have taken the lead. Gonzalez to add the PAT. He's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards. So 6 seconds. All that remains of this first half as the kick is away. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone. So we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And with Rodgers behind center, you wonder if they'll take 1 shot at this. Looking deep for Adams. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So that PI call will give them 1 more play.
And it'll be an untimed play as well. Now the half will end after this one, unless there's another defensive penalty.
A final shot before half for Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. And this is caught inside the 5. And he just falls short down at the 1-yard line. So we come upon halftime intermission here with the visiting Panthers taking the lead to the locker room. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, right, Brandon. Thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to this slimmed-down version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one has been a hard-hitting affair to this point, and you gotta expect we'll see more of the same in the second half. And to bring the action your way, let's get it right back out to Brandon Godden.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action, ready for the third quarter. Rodgers on the return. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Offense ready to get their next drive underway. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
He hits Adams complete. And now they're in the hurry up. First down carry by Jones. Oh, look at the juke. Room here to run. Now he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now a play fake. Rodgers. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. And only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30. Throwing is Rodgers on third down. He's got his man, Valdez-Scantling. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
On second down, Dillon pushes him over and stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They fake the give. Now Rodgers. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down. So let's sort this out. Costly penalty there. A lineman got downfield, and for the moment, that cost him 6 points. Now Rodgers. It's complete on the bubble screen. That's Cobb. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
And he's going to go down just outside of the 5, right around the 6-yard line. They'll wind up losing 3 there on the sack, and that makes things tougher here on third and goal.
What, go to 50, and you block over here.
Here's Jones. He's going to be very close to a first down. Good running, but looks like he's a yard short. 6 yards puts him right on the doorstep, but now it'll be fourth and goal. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. The offense is staying out there. Here we go on fourth and goal from the one. They'll run it with Jones. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Green Bay touchdown. Aaron Jones punching it in from a yard away. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. This defense held out as long as they could, but ultimately the running game wears them down from the 1 yard line.
And that gets set up throughout the entire drive, doesn't it? And when you put those big bodies and determination into that carry, the end result, touchdown.
Now Crosby for the point after. Crosby connects on the extra point, and that will tie our game here in the third. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. Abdul is going to stay put, and the drive will start at the 25. The Panthers offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. Their halftime lead now evaporated. We're back to level following that touchdown a moment ago.
And that shouldn't change the mindset a whole lot from an offensive perspective, because they already knew this was going to be a hard-fought game. Now they just need to go out, execute their game plan, and keep moving.
And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45.
The coverage was terrific downfield because...
Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Third quarter, all tied up. This is second and 10. Back to throw, Darnold. Over the middle, complete. That's Marshall. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And now Anderson is slow to get up, staying down after that last play. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. They'll look to throw again. Thomas has got it, complete. And flags come in as he gets forward for about 3 yards. And let's check on the call.
Holding offense.
They were looking to throw, holding on the big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. Usually got to pick up a holding call.
Going back to Marshall. He's got him again. So the completion good for 7 there. And it'll be second and 11. Throwing again is Darnold. Buying time to his left. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. That is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Darnold on third down. Eluding the pressure right. Open space inside the 10. And down to the 7-yard line.
These type of plays are backbreakers for a defense. They thought they had him hemmed in, thought they were going to get him on the ground with the pass rush, but were unable to do so. He gets away, picks up a big first down, and sets up first and goal inside the 10.
And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down. Again, McCaffrey showed off the footwork, but still corralled shy of the 5 at the 6. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. Now Darnold on third and goal. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Touchdown, Panthers. Ian Thomas, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the Panthers answer back with a touchdown of their own to break our tie and take the lead here in the fourth. Gonzalez good on the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Rodgers going to return it from his end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Green Bay offense ready to take over. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. And he'll be corralled right around the 34.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
Oh, trying to get that to Adams, but that's intercepted. It's Shaq Thompson here with a pick. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. So now it appears they're going to accept the penalty, which means take away the interception. Also means keep your defense on the field. Don't understand this one one bit. On first and 10, Darnold got his man complete over the middle. It's Marshall. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. Darnold will hand off to McCaffrey, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here, second down.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out, or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. They follow up the gain of 2 with a gain of 1 that time. Charles, defensively, one timeout left. Do you use it here, or do you let it roll to the 2-minute warning?
I would use it here because you're going to get the 2-minute warning stoppage as well. And then that means you have to snap the ball again. Something could happen. Something could go awry. You could get the ball back. I wouldn't let it run.
Throwing here on third down, Darnold. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
How about this defense? They came up with a couple big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up fourth down.
Gonzalez's kick is good. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. So that one, CD, going to make the road back a lot more difficult.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. You know they were praying on the other sideline for a miss because now As you pointed out, a very difficult road. Down two scores, you don't just need a touchdown. You need a chain of events to go your way. You've got to score, somehow get the ball back, and score again. The odds of that happening, not great in your favor.
Number 12 back out there. Aaron and his Packer teammates set to begin their drive. And the stats on the screen tell the story. A great start. This defense, they made some good adjustments, though. He's fallen off since.
Have to like what they did at the half, but you also have to like the fact that they hung in there. Despite the fact they had a tough first half, he was locked in, right? Rocking and rolling. They came out, made their adjustments, got their confidence back. Now they're causing them all sorts of trouble.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Now Rodgers. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Now the question is obvious. Do you try to kick the field goal right here knowing that you need two scores? I would be thinking about it if I were on that sideline. Get the field goal now, try and get the touchdown later.
Space to run past the 20. And he's got it all the way down to the 12-yard line. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Back to throw, Rodgers. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
The kick by Crosby is good, and this is back down to a 7-point game. Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. Here's Abdullah from his end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And they've got this one in hand. No timeouts remaining defensively, so this one should just be one kneel and then handshakes. Darnold is going to take a knee, and that should just about do it. So this one is over, a victory for Carolina. And we talk so much about the turnover battle, determining who wins, who loses. This game, no exception. Air-free football, no turnovers at all, and they win it.
So this is one you don't have to convince your team that what you're saying is accurate. And you know what I'm talking about. Head coach always stands up in front of the team and says, guys, if we do this, this, and this, we'll win. And usually they say, if we win the turnover battle, we'll win. Well, here's the proof right there. Win the turnover battle, go on to victory. Now the guys believe, you move on to the next lesson where you have to convince them. This one is now planted.
For us, for Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. From Lambeau, good night, everybody.